kind of instinctual. You wake up in the morning, and even when you're a kid, you look around and you see things that bother you, see things that are stupid, that don't make sense, and you say, I want to do something about that. You know, I don't want to be a zombie and sleep through my life. I want to have an impact upon the world in which I live.
I have said to myself, the mirrors come by me. Who's that bandit? Stranger on his knees.
Why they're not voting for legislation, which he doesn't understand. I've seen a tremendous increase in their income. Their function is to make money, not to avoid healthcare, hungry, and sleep out on the streets, lack adequate healthcare or education.
Competing against people with a minimum wage of
50%.
So if we're going to come up, I guess it's not interesting, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Speaker, there are three immediate concerns that I have regarding the current tragedy. In fact, laying the groundwork for more and more wars in that region in years to come.
If we could do it 50 years ago, we damn well can and must do it today.
Real change takes place when people look around them and they suddenly say the status quo is wrong.
Good evening, and thank you very much for joining me. Election days come and go, but political and social revolutions that attempt to transform our society never end. They continue in the fight to create a nation and world of social and economic justice. That's what the trade union movement is about. That's what the civil rights movement is about. That's what the women's movement is about. That's what the gay rights movement is about. That's what the environmental movement is about. That's what the political revolution is about. And that's why the political revolution must continue into the future.